have a look at this. Can we see it? A random sunflower has grown in Rolly's paddock. Probably a sunflower seed fallen out from one of his feeds. And it's just grown in his paddock. And it's facing the right way. Like it's facing towards us. How weird is that? I love that. We are going to grow. We've got some sunflower seeds. We are going to plant some all along the back fence once we start our wild garden. But yeah, have a look at that. Just a random sunflower in the middle of his paddock. What do you reckon, Rolly? And Rolly hasn't even destroyed it. I mean, he's blocked off from this side at the moment because we've just mowed it and we don't want him eating all that big chunks of grass. But yeah, just a freaking random sunflower. Gorgeous.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to another day of Vlogmas. I am in such a good mood today. Oh my gosh, I am so happy. So I weighed myself today. It's been officially a week since starting my new eating plan, and I've literally lost 3 kilos in 1 week. Oh my God. I can't believe it. Like, it's not really such a shock because I was literally weighing myself every single day. Because I was so worried about eating carbs that I just thought the weight is going to pile on the minute I start eating carbs. But yeah, 3 kilo loss. So I went from 116 when I started and I'm officially 113. I think it was pretty much 3 kilos exactly, actually. Let me just get my weigh in. Yeah, 3 kilos exactly. So hopefully you can see that there. Oh my gosh, I am over the moon. So I am going to stick with this eating plan because in all honesty, I have not felt deprived once. I feel like I've eaten more food this week than I've ever done on keto, even though I never starved myself on keto and I always ate when I was hungry and ate till I felt full and I never felt like I was hungry on keto, but I just feel like I'm eating a lot more food during this diet. And, you know, I have heard that if you don't eat enough, it can actually slow your weight loss, which is a concept I just, like, I can't get my head around, but I don't know. I mean, granted, too, I have been doing my exercise religiously, so that has probably made a big difference as well. But I'm just so happy that I can actually eat. Like, there's nothing off limits and I'm still losing the weight. I'm really happy. So I just thought I'd share with you what I'm having for breakfast this morning. So I've got 2 pieces of sourdough bread. I've got about 5 grams of butter. I'm weighing everything exactly at the moment, just until I can get used to portion sizes and how much everything is. Eventually, you know, once I know, I won't be so religious about weighing stuff, but I think just when I'm starting out, it's important for me to realize this is what 5 grams looks like. This is what a serving size looks like. So basically got 2 sourdough breads, 5 grams of butter just on the both the breads, like 2.5 each. I've got 2 eggs, a sprinkling of cheese. I think it was about 15 grams of cheese. Some shallots, salt, pepper, and some basil leaves because we've got a basil plant growing and I'm just obsessed with basil at the moment, so I put it on everything. So that is my breakfast and I've got a huge glass of cold water. I've already had my coffee this morning, so I'm still having my regular coffee as if I was doing keto. I just have black coffee and I put 2 tablespoons of cream in it, and that sort of keeps me going from about as soon as I get up, basically, like when I start work at 8 and now it's 11. And yeah, this is when I usually have my first, pretty much my lunchtime, I guess. So yeah, I'm so excited. Like, I'm just really feeling positive that it's gonna work and that I'll be able to participate in life as a normal person. So yeah, super excited about that. Oh, I have finished for the day. Seriously, I thought today was never going to end. Oh my God, what a day. Okay, now, Vlogmas day four. What are we doing? So, have to work out something for dinner because we are not prepared. We don't have anything out. And I was thinking bulldog noodles, but then I'm thinking I could have them. My calorie allowance allows me to have them. But is it a healthy choice for my body? And I actually decided on making a teriyaki salmon bowl instead, which I think will be equally delicious and will probably nourish my body a little bit better than bulldog noodles. So we're making smart choices here. Even though there's probably not a lot of difference in calories, if I'm honest, probably only about maybe 200 calories difference, the bulldog having more, like especially the way I make them, like I put like two fried eggs on top as well as having cheese and cream and everything. So yeah, they're probably roughly about 1,000 calories. I think I've got about 1,200 still left for today. So the salmon bowls we've worked out are going to be around 800. And then that will still allow me 200 or so to have either a cup of tea and a little gingerbread biscuit later on, which will be nice because I like finishing my night off with a little gingerbread biscuit and a cup of tea. So yeah, we're going to do that, I think. I'm not going to make them yet because I got some salmon out, but I'm not going to make it yet because I've just messaged Michael to see if he wants me to make him one as well. So I'm waiting to get a reply back from him as to how much I make. So we'll wait for him to reply. Happy to report we got the dishwasher fixed. I'm not sure if I've mentioned that in another video. It was one of the water pipes, had a big split in it. And yeah, it was basically just leaking into the tray and tripping off the flood little device. So that was good. We fixed that. It was only a $20 fix, $18 fix. So we're all good to go as far as the dishwasher goes. What I did want to update you guys on too is I did a... let me put some lights on. We've got all the blinds shut because it's been so freaking hot today. So I've got all the blinds shut to keep all the heat out. And I haven't even put any of the Christmas lights on today. Let me do that. But look at these dumb plants. Like, they're all... Oh, I'll have to go out and show you. And yes, you guys that mentioned they are gladioli, yes, you are correct. But have a look at them. They're all committing suicide. They're just too big, and like that one's fully died because, like I said, it snapped off at the bulb. That one, like that white stem there, has completely snapped off. These are hanging so bad. Like, this one's about to snap. These two have snapped. Like, what's going on with these plants? Like, really? Why? Are we supposed to put stakes on them or what? They're just too heavy to grow. So anyway, I said to Michael, I think these ones are just like a one-time grow and then that's it. So I said, don't plant them again. We'll plant something else there. Hopefully all these ones will spread out because I eventually want the whole thing just covered in plants. So yeah, definitely not bloody buying them again. Like, what a stupid, I don't know. Like, why? Why? These ones that we planted them when we first did the garden, we thought they had all died, but they've just all come up again. So they must have been still like little shoots under the ground and they've all just jumped up. Not sure what's happening with that one. That's got a few dead things on it. I think maybe Jesse will sort that one out. But yeah, all of these, these gladiolis, they're just the stupidest plant ever. So yeah, anyway, that's the update. Look at the state of Jesse. Just step back. Look at the colour of this girl when she comes home. I don't even think she's ever going to be clean ever again. She works so hard though. How many plants did you say you planted today? About 7,000 between you all. Don't pick the dog up. He's too big. You're going to drop him and hurt him. He's too big. He's just a baby. He doesn't like it. His face, he's got whale eye when you do it. And now look at all the fluff, and I've just mopped and bloody vacuumed. I don't even think the colour of you is coming up on camera as bad as it looks. You actually look nearly clean, but she's actually a whole different colour at the moment. Get her, Dave, get her. So have a look, we've got our present boxes filling up. We've got, who have we got here? Jessie, Jamie, Deef. The Deef's got the most, Dad, and then that's mine, but they're not my presents, they're presents that I'm getting for other people. So we've got, I think I've got my dad, they're all my dad's actually. So I think I want to put Blake's and Olivia's in my one, because I've already decided what I'm wanting for Christmas. I was going to get Michael to buy it for me and put it away for Christmas, but I think we'll just buy one next time. Deefy! I think we'll just buy one next time we go to Port. I've decided to buy myself an air fryer, so that's going to be my Christmas
you
present.
Want an air fryer?
Yeah, I think I'm going to use it. Like, I think I'm actually going to, especially now we're doing this like normal eating. I think it's going to come in handy. So yeah, I've been using my egg cooker.
Normal eating.
Yeah, well, not being, just eating everything, like not going, oh, I can't have that, can't have this. It's amazing. Did I tell you I lost 3 kilos this week?
You did.
3 whole kilos in 1 week.
But it's only been 2 days this week.
No, but I started on Monday last week.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and then... Yeah, 3 kilos. I mean, I'm not expecting 3 kilos every week. And like I said, I mean, I've got to put a lot of that down to the exercising as well. So either way, though, I hadn't feel deprived and I felt really good. So we're very happy. Show you my little update on my Christmas decor. So I finally got my, what do you call him? Steampunk Santa diamond painting in the frame there. I really didn't have any spot to put it, so I've just put it there for now. I think I showed you this before, but I've ordered some more little bottle brush trees off Temu that I want to just scatter in amongst all of that. So yeah, we'll probably throw a few more bottle brush trees amongst that. Trees still looking glorious. I just love the tree this year, and I may or may not have bought a few more tree picks off Temu as well while I was looking for my bottle brush trees. You know, to get the free postage, you need to buy so much. So I thought, well, we need a few more tree picks, don't we? Let's fix all this up. So yeah, we got some more tree picks coming. And I think I've already showed you the table. There's not really, I just wanted to keep it pretty simple. There's not really anything crazy on there. We got the Deef's little Christmas station set up and his little bowl there. And then in here, I've put some Christmas lights. I didn't really do much here. But yeah, like I said, I've got a few bottle brush trees coming, so I'll scatter them in amongst all of that. So yeah, that's all I've got now. It's manageable, it's just enough. I've got my little gingerbread biscuits in there for when we have a cup of tea tonight. What else? Not really anything else. So yes. Oh, the other thing I wanted to update you guys with as well, it's all a bit of updates, the Temu scent beads that I got. I won't be purchasing them again. I've been using them, they've been fine, but I don't find that the fragrance lingers like the downy ones do, or the, like, you know, the normal scent beads. And they're not lasting as long because I think the scent beads themselves weigh heavier than the regular scent beads. So you know, in your jar that you're getting, which is like a kilo, you think, oh, well, you're getting a kilo instead of half a kilo. But that 1 kilo is not lasting anywhere near as long as the half kilo. Because I think because the beads are so dense, I'm only using the small scoop. And yeah, I've pretty much finished one whole tub already. And I don't use it. I only really use it on Michael's and Jessie's clothes. So yeah, whereas I can get the scent beads, you know, the regular ones, the downy ones, they last a lot longer
And I just feel like the fragrance lingers a lot better as well. So yeah, they are cheaper, but and they don't smell bad, but I just don't feel like, I'm not gonna purchase them again, put it that way, because I just don't feel like I'm really getting value for money, because I just, yeah, the fragrance is just not there for me, and I just don't feel like they last long. So there's an honest review. So if you haven't bought them yet, maybe skip them or try them. You know, if you want to try them, try them. But yeah, I don't really think much of them. So once mine are used up, they'll be, I'm just going to stick to Downy and just wait for the, the half price specials. So what I wanted to talk about too, now let me sit down, get comfy, because I want to just have an honest chat about how Vlogmas is going to go. Because, let me fix you all up. All right, so I want to just sit down and have a bit of a chat as to how Vlogmas this year potentially may go. So the first 3 days, clearly they were all pre-recorded. So I think one of them, Vlogmas day one, was basically the Mike Tyson fight. So when was that? I think middle of November. Vlogmas day two was on the 30th of November when me and Jesse went to the Black Friday sales. And then Vlogmas day three was a bit of a health update. So pretty much now from Vlogmas day four, it's gonna be almost live. Like I'm probably gonna be a day ahead. So I'm actually filming this on the 3rd. So hopefully you'll see this on the 4th. But I'm not gonna promise that I'll do every single day. I'm gonna try, but there may be, I don't know, whatever circumstances may come up. If I don't get to do a vlog, I'll just combine a couple of days. If I don't get to upload it for whatever reason, I'll combine a few days. Because I'm not gonna kill myself this year, because it just got too much last year and I just got burnt out. And then I didn't even want to come back after Christmas. I was that burnt out and just that over it. I just thought, no, I don't want to do YouTube anymore. So I don't want to get to that point again this year. So I'm just going to see how I go. If I've got stuff to share, I'll share it and we'll put it in a daily vlog. If not, I might combine a few days and put it in one vlog that way. So yeah, I'm not going to promise an every single day, but I'm going to do my best. And I'm only going to go up until like Christmas, pretty much our Christmas day, which is, well, maybe I'll do Christmas day as well, because I think we might go to my, no, we'll go to my dad's Boxing Day. Because my dad normally does, like in the aged care where he is, they normally do like a Christmas party for everyone on Christmas Day. So we won't go up on that day because he's already got an event happening. We might go up and visit him the following day. So yeah, I'll see how I go. But I just don't want to get burnt out, that's all. So yeah, that's pretty much what I'm doing for Vlogmas this year. And I'll have to try and, we'll have to try and come up with some stuff to do. Because look, during the week, I'm not doing anything particularly Christmassy. Like I'm just working all day. So my weeks are going to be pretty boring, like as far as I don't really do much Christmassy stuff. But I do want to do a little bit of Christmas baking, maybe some Christmas cooking, like different recipes now that I can try. Do you want to go out, Deefy? Do you want to go out? Is your daddy home? No. You want to go outside? You need to do whippies? You want to do whippies? You want to go out? Let me know when you want to come back. It's bloody hot. Too hot for a husky out there. What was I saying? Yeah, so maybe a few of the days we'll do some Christmas recipes. We'll do some, I want to try some maybe Christmas cocktails. Oh yeah, that's what I was saying. Because now that I can pretty much eat whatever I want in moderation, we can try some new things. So yeah, that's what I was thinking. If you have any suggestions, leave them below, because yeah, I've been doing this for quite a few years now and I've just kind of run out of things to do. I didn't get any advent calendars this year because I just thought, I'm just over them, to be honest. And they were so expensive. Like those Lindt calendars, I think they were over $20 this year. And I'm like, I'm not paying that for just a bit of chocolate. So yeah. You didn't even want them last year.
This is ultimate charity right here.
You didn't even want them last year.
I
Wow. This year. Well, I'll get you a Cadbury one.
No, Mum, please
don't. You don't even like chocolate. Like, we were on, like, day 17 and you hadn't even opened day 2 yet.
Oh, I remember that.
Yeah. You had to open, like, about 10 bloody windows all in one day. And I'll share with you, so I've got a few, obviously I've got a few Temu hauls coming, so I'll share those with you when they arrive. I'm not really happy actually, because I think Temu has changed courier companies. I think they're with some global Team Express at the moment, and I've got about 2 or 3 shipments that are just late. I ended up getting $5 refunds off Temu because I didn't make the delivery time. One of them was due on the 25th of November and it's still not moved. Like, it was scanned at the depot on the 21st of November and it's not moved since. So I don't know what's going on with that. So that's the one with all my Christmas decor in that I bought. Well, I didn't buy decor, but yeah, I just bought some bottle brush trees and maybe some tree picks and maybe a little ornament or two. But I didn't buy any decor. Michael, if you're watching, I didn't buy anything. I'm waiting on those. I'm hoping they'll arrive this week, but I'm not gonna hold my breath. So what can we do? I'm gonna message Michael to see what he wants to do about dinner. And if he decides he doesn't want a salmon bowl, I think we might start making that now and have an early dinner, because then I can have my cup of tea and little gingerbread biscuit early tonight while I'm watching a Christmas movie. Oh, I've just started watching. I mean, I'm trying to catch up with everyone's Vlogmases on YouTube as well. I'm really already behind. I'm not gonna keep up, I know this. But I started watching, what was it called? It's got Lindsay Lohan in it and the guy from Pretty Little Liars. I think it's called something Our Little Secret or some Little Secret or something like that. I have just started watching it, so I don't know how it's going to be. But, you know, Christmas movies are just cheesy as all heck. I want to like Christmas movies, but I just really don't. I don't enjoy them. I want to be that person that sits with a hot chocolate watching them and loving them, but I really don't like them. Like, if it's not someone saving grandma's bloody Christmas tree farm, or, you know, someone falling in love, I don't know. It's just all the same crap, isn't it?
But Christmas tree farm.
Yeah, the Christmas tree farm. But yeah, so I started watching that. And the guy from Pretty Little Liars, like, and that's a modern movie, so it was released this year. And the guy that's from Pretty Little Liars that's in it, I think his name's Ian Harding. I'm pretty sure that's his real name. He looks like he's 10 years younger in this film than he was back when he was filming Pretty Little Liars. And, like, how long ago was that show? Like, that, at least, it's got to be at least 10 years ago, that show. Surely. It's amazing. And even Lindsay Lohan, like, she's nearly, she'd have to be in her 40s, surely. And she looks like she's, like, in her late 20s. I don't know, they're aging backwards in Hollywood. Maybe all the, I don't know what is in the water there, but yeah, they both look incredibly young, unless it's face filters, who knows.
All right, well, Michael didn't want any, and he doesn't know what he's missing out on. So I've just made some for myself. So this is my, I don't know what you would call it, salmon bowl, sushi in a bowl. We've got a cup of rice under there. We've got, I think I've got about 200 grams of salmon. This is like frozen salmon that I just fried in some sesame oil and soy. We've got some red onion. We've got a homegrown cucumber, and because I'm obsessed with my basil leaves, I've got a couple of basil leaves. And then those are some seaweed papers, just to, you know, make up your own little sushi wrap. So yeah, that's my healthy dinner tonight. Probably a lot more nourishing than the bull duck was gonna be, but I can always have it another day.
Well guys, since everyone is doing a help yourself night tonight, I'm gonna sit and have my dinner now, And I think I might finish today's vlog off here. So I can get something up to you guys. Hope you're enjoying Vlogmas so far, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Thanks for watching.